Hello! In this video, you will learn about the Automotive SPICE process called Software Integration and Integration Test. To keep it short and sweet, we will focus on the three most important points of this process. My name is Klaus Hermann, and I'm a principal assessor and trainer for Automotive SPICE. It is my passion to bring hard-to-understand models to life so that people can understand them. All right, let's get started. First of all, why is this process important? In my classes and assessments, I get a lot of questions like, hey, we do a huge amount of requirements testing. Is the extra effort for integration testing really worth it? So, what's your opinion? Ever thought about it? To answer this question, we must first clarify what integration tests mean. The purpose of integration tests is to check the compliance with the software architecture. This includes checking the interfaces, dynamic behavior, and resource consumption according to SWE.2, the software architectural design process. Therefore, let's modify our initial question to, can requirements tests prove conformity with the software architecture? And the answer is, of course not, simply because these tests test against requirements and not against the architecture. So far, so good. But some of you might say, okay, got it, but what is the added value of testing against the architecture anyway? If the functionality works well, isn't that good enough? Well, let's take a closer look. Can an architecture-related error be found in requirements testing? Yes, it can, but there is no guarantee. You could multiply the number of requirement tests by 1,000, 10,000, 100,000, but there is still no guarantee of that. The cost would explode, but the software would still have errors that could have been avoided simply by testing against the architecture. Now, here's the bottom line. Performing integration testing gives you more robust software at a lower cost compared to exhaustive requirements testing. Congratulations! You now belong to the exclusive circle of people who understand the value of this process. Okay, let's take a look at the three most important points of the software integration and integration test process. Point number one is define a strategy for integration and for integration testing. As you may know from some of our videos, a strategy is an easy-to-understand instructional description. This is especially important for larger, distributed projects, so that all people know how we do it. All right, this strategy first describes the workflow of the software team, starting with the individual developer who could perform some simple integration tests before delivering his software into the team work stream. And then the team could perform some integration tests as part of its nightly test runs. And when they are finished, they would perform some final integration tests before delivering their work into the project work stream, where some additional integration testing happens. In addition, Automotive SPICE requires a regression test strategy. Regression testing simply means that if you change something in the software, you make sure that everything that hasn't changed still works well. A practical example: if you use continuous integration, you typically run all integration tests again during your nightly tests. So, the strategy would be simply the sentence I just said. Point number two is providing bidirectional traceability and consistency to the software architecture. Traceability means that for each relevant architectural element, such as an interface, you can localize the corresponding test. If you can do this vice versa, then the traceability is bidirectional. Now, what does consistency mean? In our previous example, consistency would require that the interface is linked to the correct test and not to the test of something else. This test is suitable to test the interface completely. If this is not the case, additional tests must be linked. Consistency also requires that the tests actually test the interface correctly. In other words, no faulty tests. Now coming to point number three. Summarize and communicate the test results. This is usually referred to as a test summary report. And this summary report should be sent to the people who need this information, such as the development team, project manager, quality engineers, and so on. Let's take a closer look at how this report should look. As the name suggests, it should summarize the results and hide unnecessary details. What is the main message that the summary report should convey? Well, it should, of course, show compliance with the software architecture. I'll give you a counterexample that I often see in my assessments. The report contains pie charts showing the 539 tests that should have been performed, but of which 75 could not be performed and 34 failed. That's it. There's no information as to why the 75 tests could not be carried out and what the risks are. There's also no information about how big the problem is with the 34 failed tests. Nor does the report show compliance with the software architecture. In fact, the software architecture is not mentioned at all. They would have to relate the pie chart to the 247 architectural elements, not just to the 539 tests. I think you got the point. And that's it. I hope this has broadened your horizons. If you need more information about this process, you can download a software integration and integration test white paper from our website. It's free. You can find the link in the description below. And don't forget to share this video with your colleagues. Finally, leave a thumbs up if you like the video, subscribe if you want to see more about SPICE, and check out more of our SPICE videos. Bye-bye.